day two of Ignite Conference. We're about to head into the rally session today. We've got a jam-packed schedule. So we've got Sam Brebner speaking to us this morning. Then we've got keynotes, workshops. We've got Mass celebrated by the Archbishop, lunch, dinner, all that lovely time to spend together. And then this evening, we're going to be hearing from Father Rob, and we're going to be having a time for adoration. So as you can see, all of these people anxiously are waiting to come into the morning session this morning. Are you guys excited? Yeah, got some waves. Awesome. Yeah, so we're really keen for today. Thank you for joining us online, and we're going to have an awesome day two of Ignite Conference. Let's go. I'm Tiggy. Nice to meet you. Would you mind just introducing yourself? Maybe tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm Sister Samuel, Sisters of Mary Morningstar.
Awesome.
Yeah. I'm working in Brisbane for 3 years.
Awesome, awesome. And Sissa, is this your first Ignite Conference?
My third one.
Third one, okay. Seasoned professional. I love it. What are you most looking forward to for this weekend?
Maybe, let us say, a witness of the unity of the church. Mm. Enjoying to be together because of one thing, that is our love for Christ.
Yes, that's beautiful. I think that's really nice. We're talking to some other people, and unity's been a big thing, because I think for a lot of us, like, we come from all of these different communities, and we often don't see people that share that same faith. And we come here, and it's almost like there's all of these different people from different places, and it's that one thing that unites us is Christ, and that is strong enough to kind of bring this group of all of these different people together.
Exactly.
Awesome. And Sister, do you have any maybe encouragement for people who are maybe watching at home or here at conference for, I guess, how to enter into this time?
That's true. One encouragement, of course, because since I am a contemplative sister, I would say pray, pray, and pray, and go and meet with Christ in prayer, go to adoration, take any opportunity to pray, even 5 minutes a day. It's awesome. Because he's here and he's waiting for you, and he's our rock.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Sister. Lovely to meet you. Thank you for meeting you. Hello. Can you introduce yourself? Tell us a bit about yourself, where you're from, what grade you're in.
My name's Hugh. I'm from Caloundra on the Sunshine Coast, part of Kingdom Youth. We're just a youth group in Caloundra based out of Unity College, and we've come here in a pretty large group today with a bunch of us, and we're just here to have some fun and learn a bunch about God. So that's pretty good.
Awesome, awesome. And Hugh, have you been to a conference before?
No, this is my first time at Ignite.
Yeah. First time at conference. What are you excited for? Like, have you heard much about it? Is there something that you're like, I am keen for that?
I've heard lots of things, but definitely the rallies. I'm very keen for the rallies. The first one's on tonight, so I'm just super excited. The one at the launch was super fun, so yeah. Just keen for it with everybody, so it should be fun.
Awesome, awesome. That's good. I love the excitement and that kind of openness for what is to come for conference. So awesome. Thank you for this interview. Have fun at your conference. I'll see you later. Hello, we've got some more with the Kingdom Group. Can you guys introduce yourself, where you're from, maybe what grade you're in?
Hi, I'm Matthew, and I'm from St. John's in grade 8.
Awesome. Hi, Matthew.
Hey, I'm Craig, and I'm from St. John's and grade 8, yeah.
And so for both of you, this is your first conference, am I correct? Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes, and what are you most looking forward to about the conference?
Probably just a chance to make some new friends, meet some new people.
Awesome. I love that.
Yeah, definitely making more friends is very good. Nice social thing too.
Yeah, so meeting people. And obviously, like, we're here for meeting people. We're going to be learning more about our faith, more about God, more about those sorts of things. Is there anything that you're, like, coming to conference and you're like, I really hope to learn about this or have to have an experience with God or something like that? Is there something you're bringing to conference that you're, like, have this expectation or, I guess, this openness to something? That might have been a tricky question. Can you think of anything like that? Not really? Pretty open to what will happen this weekend? What about you, Craig? What about you, Craig?
Just open to new experiences, I guess. So.
Awesome. Open to new experiences. I think that's the way to be when you're going to something new you haven't been to. Being open. Speaking of new experiences, thank you for interviewing. It's been awesome seeing you guys around. I'll see you around. Okay, would you guys like to introduce yourselves? Tell us maybe where you're from, that sort of thing.
I'm Matt. I'm from Brisbane. what else do I say? I'm stoked to be here. This is I don't know what number of conferences I've been to, but this is probably like over 5, I don't know. So yeah, new venue, new atmosphere, like new people. It's gonna, really keen.
Awesome. Thanks, Matt.
To my brother. Sweet.
Yep, I'm Xavier. I'm from B-Town, Balbarrie, that is. And that's the 4070, and I'm his brother. So, yeah, that about sums that up.
Yep.
Awesome. And so you guys are obviously conference veterans. You've been here many times before. What are your kind of hopes, or what are you excited for about this conference this year?
I'll go. It's at a new venue, which is pretty exciting. It's pretty awesome to be here. It's a lot closer to us, at least, to where the last one was. So that's pretty awesome. And, I'm just pretty keen because it's like the new feeling, you know what I mean? Holy Spirit working in a different place, which is awesome.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah, I've seen it from a bit of a different perspective this year. Like, I'm serving in the band, which is a huge honor. And, like, I'm just really excited to see, like, from, I guess, behind the scenes and just witness people, you know, encountering the Lord and, yeah, having some really life-changing experiences. So I'm just keen to see that from a new perspective, yeah.
Awesome, awesome. And so maybe for someone, I know like first day of conference, there's sometimes like a bit of jitters, sometimes people are a bit nervous to be here, maybe a bit unsure of what is coming. What would be maybe some words of like encouragement that you'd have for people who maybe are feeling a bit unsure or not really confident in being here? What would your encouragement be to them?
Yep, all right. You've probably got this answer already, but just like be open, you know, like just... let go. Don't be too hard on yourself. Like, don't put too much pressure on yourself. Don't put too much pressure. Just don't put too much pressure on anyone. Just sort of, yeah, just breathe, be where you're at. Don't like worry. Just, yeah, chill. Like, let the experience just take you, like, come along for the ride sort of thing.
Awesome. I love what you said, like, be where you're at. Like, I think sometimes we can come to things and we can be like, I need to be this way or I need to do this certain thing. But it's just like, you can just be yourself. If you're nervous, that's okay. Be nervous, but be open to kind of what's to come. That was awesome. Thanks, Matt. Feeling encouraged.
I'll just say it's kind of a similar thing, but it's more instead of like, I think Matt was kind of talking about being open and not being afraid of like what other people think. I kind of feel like more there's a lacking of like openness to the Spirit sometimes. And so, you know, like and you'll see it when like days forward come and, you know, there's more like excitement in the rallies, but like, you know, sometimes from the first day you can have that kind of openness to the Spirit and it can really like make it the conference for you if you like just be open from the start. So yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much. I hope your conference goes really, really well. Thank you for being interviewed. Awesome. Okay, see you guys around. Come on in. Maybe you guys can go around and just like maybe say your name, where you're from, if this is your first conference or if you're like a seasoned professional. I'm Tiggy, by the way. Nice to meet you all.
I'm John Paul. I'm from Adelaide and this is my first conference.
Awesome. Welcome, John Paul.
I'm Caitlin. This is my fourth conference. Yeah.
Awesome. Are you from Adelaide as well? Yeah. Awesome. You guys are all Adelaide group? Adelaide. Woo! Awesome. Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Awesome.
Hello, I'm Fabio and this is my first one as well.
First one. Welcome. Welcome.
I'm Manuel, and I was the first one in 2019, so this is my second.
Awesome, second conference, very good, very good.
I'm Nathan, and this is my third conference.
Oh my goodness, nice to see you, Nathan. I met Nathan a couple of years ago in Adelaide. Wow, you've grown, sorry. Good to see you, Nathan.
I'm Mary, and this is my first conference as well.
Awesome, welcome. So, wait, who's been to conference before? Awesome, okay. For those of us who haven't been before, maybe people who are watching on, what are some things that maybe we can expect or look forward to in this conference? Or what was your like favourite part from a conference you've been to previously?
Emmanuel Worship is amazing and the night rallies are something to behold.
Night rallies, something to behold. What's like your favourite part of the night rally? Is it like...
Because there's obviously different parts, like there's the hype up and, you know, everyone's jumping around and it's just this insane worship. But then there's also the mellower moments where you just get really deep in your faith and in your praise and worship and it's really nice. Yeah.
Beautiful, I love it. We get like the celebration, we get that deep prayer, we get kind of all of the different parts. Beautiful, beautiful. Someone else who's been before, tell us a bit about your favourite part.
Well, the food, that's always fun. Like you got the, four or five vans down here. It's the best food I've had in a while. And then obviously got Emmanuel Worship. They're the awesome. CDs are just amazing. And everything else about them is just, yeah, fun. It's the atmosphere in general. I just go everywhere. Everyone's loving a time here. So, yeah, it's it.
Awesome, awesome. And Nathan, anything you want to add?
I guess just that sense of community. Like everyone being around and just coming together from all over Australia and just coming together to celebrate our faith. I think that's really special.
Yeah, it's really beautiful. Like we get to see like what the church is like all over Australia. That's awesome. And so for those of you, first time here, you guys have any expectations? Anything that you're really looking forward to? Let's go first.
actually, we're looking forward to Confession Adoration, I think. Yeah, and everyone's telling me about the rallies, hyping me up about it. So, yeah, very, very stoked for that. But, yeah, I think all of that, yeah.
Awesome. I love it. So having those experiences of the sacrament, that encounter, love it, love it. What about you, JP? Anything that you're looking
for? Similar to Mary. I'm like the worship sessions I'm keen for. But also, confession and the masses. And, yeah, I think also meeting new people. I think that's probably something to look forward to for sure.
Awesome, awesome. And lucky last?
Yeah, I think the same as, you know, JP and Mary. Getting to know new people. I love meeting people that are Catholic as well, and just being able to hear their story and, you know, have those deep chats with the new people. And praise and worship's always up there, isn't it? Yeah.
Awesome. Well, it's been so lovely to meet you all. Hope you have a great conference. Thank you for being interviewed. I'm Tiggy. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Imi.
Lovely. Imi, where are you from?
Narrabri, New South Wales.
Awesome. Narrabri. My brother used to work on the cotton farm in Narrabri, so that's cool. I didn't know where else to live out there. Awesome. So, is your first conference, Imi?
It's like my fourth or something.
Awesome. Okay.
Yeah.
Very cool, very cool. And what are you looking forward to about conference this year?
Oh, getting pretty lit, having a good one.
And getting excited. And what is something, maybe, do you kind of come with, like, expectations? Like, you've been to conference before. Yeah. What sort of things are you, like, hoping to experience at conference this year?
Just meeting heaps of people, you know, having a good time, making friends.
Awesome. I love it, Imi. Well, enjoy your conference. Thanks. Good to see you. All right. Good morning. Here we are at day two of Ignite Conference. Just before the morning session, you can see behind us all of these chairs that are about to be filled. And I'm here with this morning's speaker, Sam Brebner. Sam, could you just introduce yourself and tell us a bit about yourself?
Yeah, absolutely. Good morning, everyone. My name is Sam Brebner. I'm all the way from New Zealand and really excited to be speaking at the morning rally this morning. I'm going to be talking about who we are, about our identity, about the fact that we are made in the image of God, and how, you know, in our world there can be all of these things that try to distract us from that, all of these things that make us forget about who we are. But God wants to remind us. He wants to let us know that we are his sons and daughters, that we're made in his image, and we've been made for a purpose. So super excited to get the morning started.
Awesome. Thanks, Sam. And I'm super keen to hear what you have to say this morning. I think the topic of identity is so important. And being aware of who we are. So really excited to hear you talk this morning, and we'll see you there. Show me life like it's supposed to be. An oasis, here awaits us. All the freedom I'll ever need. Now I'm alive. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, yeah, I'm alive. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go.
Show me life like it's supposed to be. An oasis, who awaits us, or the freedom I'll ever need. Now I'm alive. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I fly alive. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I fly alive. Woo! La 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 la. When I let go.
You guys excited? I know I am excited. Last night was amazing. I can't stop thinking about what Maddie was saying. And I think maybe some of you guys still have some things in your head as well. So how about you take a moment, turn to the people around you and just share with you, what was it that you heard or felt last night that really, really stuck with you?
Or maybe, what was one of your favourite new songs that you heard Emmanuel Worship play last night?
Oh, how good.
If you can remember.
What about, I think, is it Room, that first new one
yes,
they played?
Oh, yes, Room, that's one of them.
That was a beautiful, beautiful song.
to turn to the person on the other side of you, introduce yourself, and tell them how much sleep you got last night.
Beth, how much sleep did you get last night?
Well, I got home, had some chicken nuggets.
Oh, chicken nuggets, nice.
And then I went to bed and I woke up at 5:30.
Oh, that's pretty good.
My daughter woke up. How about you, Pete? Pete, how much sleep did you get?
Last night, I think I slept all right, maybe 6 hours.
Oh, nice,
Pretty good for me.
That's good. Now, yesterday, Pete and I introduced ourselves to you, but now we want to know a little bit about who's in the room with us for the next few days. You. Where are you from? The Sunny Coast.
Is anyone else from the Sunny Coast? Whoa. Oh, okay, we got a fair few from the Sunny Coast.
Represent the Sunny Coast.
Where else have we got? What other groups have we got
anyone
in here?
Anyone else? Yeah, where are you from? Is anyone else here from, I'm going to cabbage that to Brisbane. This man's from Trinity College in Beenleigh. Is anyone else here from Brisbane?
Well,
Brisbane, wow, the Sunny Coast people are a bit louder than you guys.
I heard a bit of Charters Towers area, anywhere around there, North Queensland.
Okay, I got one. Is anyone here? Can you make some noise if you came here from Cairns?
We've got a decent... What about Mount Isa? Yeah, we've got some people from Mount Isa.
What about... Can you make some noise if you're here from Rockhampton? Yeah,
amazing.
I see you.
And the question I have is, do we have people here from Lismore? They're starting
Hello.
To come.
Welcome.
Welcome. I'm sure we'll have many more people from Lismore rocking up throughout today, though, won't we?
Do we have, make some noise if you're from Townsville. Oh, yeah. No,
Townsville,
you're not from Townsville.
Over there.
Liar.
Wow, we've got people from all over.
Oh, that's funny. Is there anywhere we missed? I can't hear.
Was I hearing something? They want me to say Ipswich. Anyone from Ipswich?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got some from Ipswich.
There's a solid support group from Ipswich.
We got a big group from Ipswich, yeah.
Oh, well, we're so glad wherever you came from that you decided to come here for your weekend.
We are so excited to spend this weekend with you guys from wherever you have come from, yes.
So, we don't want you to go anywhere. We've actually going to welcome up Emmanuel Worship to play some more songs for you. So, if you haven't already, stand up and get involved. Look at our amazing band already on the stage.
Let's go!
Good. Thank you, Beth and Pete. Now, last night was a really, really fun night. I don't know about you, but Emmanuel Worship had a lot of fun out here. Maybe this was your first night of a praise night. Who was its first time ever experiencing something like last night? A few of you. A few of you are really familiar with it. Hey, what was that thing that a lot of people were doing that was maybe a little different? It was maybe raising up their hands in the air. Did anyone see somebody raising up their hands or holding it low? I can see some nods, maybe, yes. We were definitely doing that. And over this conference, we're going to invite you to maybe be a little bit brave and opening up your hands, because when we do that, we're actually being open to God. Just another way of connecting with Him. And I saw a lot of you before were putting up your hands. I never felt lighter, never felt freedom like this. That's what it's going to feel like when you put it up there. Might feel a little bit awkward at first. Why don't we get the awkwardness away right now? Come on, we're all friends here. Why don't we just put up our hands, or some are full sending it up the top right now. If you feel brave enough, lifting up your hands like that, we're showing that we're open to God. That is awesome. I see people at the back as well raising up their hands. If you're not quite there yet, maybe you start low, maybe do a little baby hands. Why don't we practice that this morning? And I'm going to continue to invite you guys, because we love doing it. That's what this conference is about. We love being free in praising God and connecting with Him. So we're going to worship this morning using our hands, raising up our hands, lifting up our voices. Sing along with us. Why don't we give it a go right now, hey?
This is the moment. All right, you guys can get a bit sweaty together. Is that okay? Yeah? Yeah!
Guys, here's a new song. Let's sing it out. Table set for me.
it's set for me. Yeah. Longing for mercy, you reach out your hand. Longing for justice, cry out for the slain. Longing for peace, oh, you come to storm. This is my Father's promise, I know. Yeah. I've seen suffering, a world that's full of hope. The freedom's coming, waiting for us.
Are you free to give?
Will you freely give of you?
Body blood.
Body blood of you.
Longing for mercy.
Longing for mercy. You reach out your hand. Longing for justice. Cry out for the slain. Longing for peace. Oh, you come to storm. And this is my Father's.
Let me see your hands in the air. Come on. That's it. Very nice.
Project Kindy. One particular moment happened in Malawi, Africa. I went there in 2017 to visit the Kenoshan sisters and see the kindergarten mission that we fundraise for. One day the sisters were taking me around to see the different kindergartens. At one particular village, the chief actually spoke to me after we'd spent time with the children and the mums, and this didn't happen at any other kindergarten. Through the translation of the sister, I understood that he said, "Where we live is poor. Other villages might get good rain and have plenty of food. But as you can see, we live on rocky ground and we don't get as much rain. So we always have less." And then he went on and he said, "I told my neighbors that you were coming today and they didn't believe me. They laughed at me. But you coming to see us has really encouraged me. And the kindergarten means a lot to our whole community. We are the neglected ones. We're forgotten. So thank you." Normally when I tell that story, I'm in tears because the impact that his words had on me were quite profound. Because I was expecting to see how powerful it was that the children had food to eat when they suffer food insecurity. Because being a mum with little kids, I knew that was going to mean a lot to me. But I wasn't expecting to hear how important the work was for the adults in the villages. So it really surprised me. But something happened in that conversation where Jesus used his words to pierce through my heart with a heavenly sword and draw me closer to him and deeper into the work, deeper into the mission, and deeper into the call to love him and his family are the poor. And so it actually gives me a deep sense of meaning and peace and hope to love the poor and to love Jesus.
Okay, so far we've had a great morning rally, lots of upbeat music, lots of great times with Emmanuel Worship, and now we're going to head into our input for this morning. So last night we heard an amazing talk from Maddie Wilson, and now I'm going to introduce to you who's doing our talk this morning. So this person, they did live in Australia for a little bit with their little family, but he has returned home to New Zealand, where his OG home. Yeah, make some noise. Is anyone here from New Zealand? Oh, nice. Well, that's where this next speaker is from, and he does live there now with his little family. He's got a new baby and a two-year-old, and they are gorgeous little daughters. And he works for the Diocese of Auckland in New Zealand, and he's so excited to be back here in Australia to talk to you guys a little bit about who we are in the moment. So sometimes we get a bit lost, but this person is here to remind us and tell us some truths. So can you please join me in making some noise for Sam Brebner?
Good morning. Are you ready for day two? Woo! Far out, it is good to be here. This morning, I'm going to tell you about the moment when my life completely changed. But before that, I want to tell you about my first primary school teacher. Her name was Nolene Hamilton, and Mrs. Hamilton was a good primary school teacher. She'd been in the business for over 40 years, very few crayons got eaten on her watch. And Mrs. Hamilton's favorite piece of advice was just be yourself. She would say this all the time, at times even when it didn't really make sense. Like, I remember this one time, we were in class and we had to read out a story that we had written in front of the class. And it might surprise you to hear this, but I was nervous. I was really nervous. I was so nervous that I was sitting in my chair just shaking, just waiting for my turn. And eventually my turn arrived, and Mrs. Hamilton walked over to my chair, and in this very encouraging way, she said, "It's all right, Sam. Just be yourself." And I remember sitting there and thinking, Mrs. Hamilton, myself does not want to read the story in front of the class. Like, if anything, I need to be someone else right now, someone that likes reading stories out loud. And so right from my first year of primary school, I didn't like this advice to just be yourself. Because every time Mrs. Hamilton told me to be myself, I felt like I didn't know who myself was. It only got worse when I got to high school. You know, my parents, my coaches, my teachers, they were all telling me, "Sam, just be yourself." But I remember, you know, I would look in the mirror and I wouldn't even really know who the guy was staring back at me. I didn't know who I was. I didn't know who to be. You know, in the Bible, in the very first chapter of the very first book, it says this: God created humankind in his image. It's kind of like when you see a painting or a sculpture of someone, it reveals something about the original person. You know, you can look at the painting and get some insight into who this person was, how they looked, their posture, how they held themselves, who they were. What this verse is saying is that there is something about us that reveals God. There's something about who we are that reflects who God is. And it's no accident that this verse is in the very first chapter of the very first book, because it's kind of the foundation for the whole rest of the story. And in my opinion, it is the greatest story that has ever been written. But I would have to say, in a close second place, would have to be The Lion King. Can I just see, show of hands, who here has seen The Lion King? Hands up if you have seen The Lion King. All right, I want you to keep your hands up. Keep your hands up if you have seen the OG 2D 1994 Lion King. Good, good. All right, hands down. This movie was my childhood. And for those of you that haven't seen it, The Lion King is a movie about a little lion named Simba. And Simba is destined to become the king. And so his father, Mufasa, the current king, is slowly teaching him everything that he knows. But while Simba is still a little lion cub, his father tragically dies. And what is, without a doubt, the saddest piece of cinema for children under the age of 10. Mufasa dies, and Simba doesn't know how to deal with it. And so he runs away. He runs away from his grief. He runs away from his home. He runs away from who he's supposed to be. And eventually he gets found by these two animals, a meerkat and a warthog named Timon and Pumbaa. And Timon and Pumbaa, have got this motto, these two words that they love to live by. And the two words are? Hakuna Matata. And Hakuna Matata means? No worries. And so they introduce Simba to this no worries lifestyle. And Timon and Pumbaa, they've got a very specific diet. No, it's not the Whole 30. Their diet is grubs and bugs. Grubs and bugs. And so Simba the lion begins his new Hakuna Matata life, living on grubs and bugs. Look, I don't know how much Discovery Channel you watch, but one thing I can tell you is that lions are not meant to live on grubs and bugs. Simba is meant to be the king of the jungle, the fiercest, the biggest, the proudest. And yet he's feeding himself on grubs and bugs. And it would be fair to say at this point that Simba has forgotten who he is. When I was in high school, I found myself in a similar situation. I started hanging out with this group of friends that wasn't the best. Like, these were the guys at the back of the science lab melting pens in the Bunsen burner. And I remember in this group of mates just always feeling this pressure to act like I didn't care. Like I didn't care about my parents, like I didn't care about school, like I didn't care about how I made other people feel. You know, Hakuna Matata, no worries. And in my group of friends, it definitely wasn't cool to worry about God or worry about faith or being a good person. And so I started to squash down those parts of who I was. And the thing about my mates was if I didn't know who I was, they were quite happy to tell me who to be. And so I followed their lead. As we got a bit older, my friends started going to parties, so I started going to parties. My friends started drinking alcohol, and so I started drinking. My friends started to get into unhealthy relationships, and I started to do the same. And just like how you can't feed a lion on grubs and bugs, all of the stuff that I was doing, all of the stuff that I thought was going to make me happy, none of it really satisfied me. For Simba in The Lion King, he eventually comes to this turning point when he meets one of his father's old friends, a baboon named Rafiki. And Rafiki is definitely my favorite character in The Lion King because he speaks like this. Come here. Let me tell you a secret. Asante sana squash banana bebe 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 bana. He is this mysterious, wise, talking monkey. And Rafiki starts talking to Simba about who he is. And Rafiki says, I know who you are. You're Mufasa's boy. And I'll show him to you. And at this moment, everything stops. At the possibility of seeing his father again, you see something change in Simba. It's like he gets this brief reminder of who he's meant to be. And so he looks at Rafiki, but Rafiki runs off. And so Simba chases after him, and he's running through trees and through vines. And eventually, they get to this pool of water. And Rafiki says, stop, look down there. And Simba steps forward and he looks into the pool. And he's disappointed. That's not my father, he says. It's just my reflection. I wonder how many of us here this morning know something about Simba's disappointment. When we look in a mirror, maybe we haven't seen the image of God looking back at us. Maybe we've seen something about our appearance that we wish we could change. Something in our past we wish we could change. But we don't see the image of God. But Rafiki, he's not going to settle for this. No, he says. Look harder. And so Simba walks up to the pool again. And he looks down. And for just a moment, he sees the image of his father. For just a moment, he sees who he was created to be. And this moment leads to this incredible scene where Mufasa appears to Simba in the clouds and he speaks to him. Simba, you've forgotten who you are. Look inside yourself, Simba. You are more than what you have become. You are my son. Remember who you are. Remember. 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 Oh, literal chills. For me, my Rafiki moment came when I was 16 years old. I was going to a Catholic high school, and in my school we had this chaplain named Daniel. And one day Daniel came into one of our religious education classes, and he spoke to us about the bugs and the grubs of life. He spoke to us about how we can feel this pressure to chase popularity, you know, to fit in with a certain group of friends, to have a certain number of likes or followers. He spoke to us about peer pressure and partying and drinking. He spoke to us about unhealthy relationships. And he told us that we can often think that these are the things that are going to satisfy us. But really, they just leave us feeling empty. But Daniel also told us about God. He said that we had been created by God, that God loved us, that he loved us so much that he had sent his son Jesus into the world to die for us so that we could be forgiven for all the times that we had settled for the bugs and the grubs. He said we had been created by God for a purpose. And God wanted to have a relationship with us every single day. I remember on the bus ride home that night, I couldn't stop thinking about what Daniel had said. When I got home, I was still thinking about it. And I walked into my room and I decided to do something that I hadn't done in a long, long time. I decided to pray. And I knelt down and I said, God, if you're real, then who are you? And who am I? When I prayed that prayer, I didn't get a big Mufasa voice coming down from heaven. Samuel, take your place in the circle of life. I didn't get a Mufasa voice. But over the next few days and weeks, I feel like God started to remind me who I was. The next day at school, I started talking to Daniel and asking him all of these questions that I had about life, about faith, about church. And Daniel invited me to come along to the local parish youth group. And so I went along, and at this youth group, I made new friends. Friends that didn't peer pressure me to be a certain way, but friends that really just cared about me, you know, that appreciated me for who I was. I started to pray every day. And as I prayed, what I noticed was that emptiness that I'd been carrying for so long, it started to fade away. And I started to read the Bible, just a chapter or two every night. And it was through reading the Bible that I felt like God really started to tell me who I was. In the first letter of John, I read, "See what kind of love the Father has for us, that we should be called children of God. And so we are." In the letter to the Galatians, I read, "Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir through God." And one of my favorites was in Isaiah. God says, "Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine." See, God didn't want to leave us in any doubt about who we are. We read it in here again and again and again. We are God's sons and daughters. And the next time someone gives you the advice to just be yourself, I want you to remember that we can only know who we are when we know who God is. Because we've been created in God's image. Without God, there's no reference point. You know, no wonder there's so much confusion today about personal identity. Because without God, all we have is our self. And I can tell you from experience, that gets confusing pretty quickly. But with God, everything makes sense. And so the next time someone tells you to just be yourself, I want you to think, just be who God created me to be. Just be yourself, just be who God created me to be. Because you are his son or daughter, made in God's image, loved beyond all measure, created for a purpose. That is who you are. For me, the moment that everything changed was the moment when I invited God to tell me who I was. And he hasn't stopped telling me. Truthfully, I need to be told every single day. Because sometimes I go back to the bugs and the grubs. You know, I'll start scrolling, I'll start listening to the lies, I'll start chasing some shallow definition of success. And all of this stuff makes me forget who I really am. So I want to ask you, what are the bugs and grubs that you're munching on? Is it poor self-image? Feeling like you're too ugly, too stupid, too broken for God to do something meaningful with your life? Remember who you are. Is it some external measure of your worth You know, feeling like you've got to have a certain number of likes or followers, a certain dollar amount in your bank account, a certain level of accomplishment before you're enough. Remember who you are. Is it something in your past? You know, maybe some way that you were hurt, some choice that you regret, something that you can't shake, something that you feel like still defines you. Remember who you are. Ignite 2022. What if this was the moment where you invited God to remind you? What if this was the moment you said goodbye to the bugs and the grubs and you remembered that you are God's son or daughter, made in the image of the Most High King, loved and created for a purpose? As we dive into day two of conference, make this the moment where you remember who God is and you remember who you are.
So Ignite Conference, we're going to stand together now. If you'd love to stand with me, and we're going to respond. We're going to go into a time of worship together. We can just ask God with our hands, with our voice, with our bodies, who we are. I think a little life faith hack I've found is that no matter where you're at right now with God, God is always, his arms are always like this. Always wide open for us. No matter how perfect you feel like you've been recently or how bad you feel like you've been recently, God is always here. Ready to welcome us into his arms, ready to embrace us and show us and whisper to us of who we are. So let's ask him this morning. Come, Lord Jesus, come, Lord Jesus.
Thank you. think it's really good to sit in the silence as well. I feel like that's where we can hear the voice of God speak. I pray that right now maybe we can hear what God might want to speak to us after what we heard Sam say to us, hey? Maybe you need to ask God, hey, who do you say that I am? Maybe it's loved, maybe it's good, maybe it's worthy, all those things. Let's take a moment now to listen to what God might want to say to us this morning.
Jesus, always generous, Jesus. Table. thank you so much for this time. We've been able to receive the word that Sam got to speak to us this morning, the ways that we come and tell us that we are loved. I pray that throughout this conference, we get to discover more of who we are, that we have more moments to find more about ourselves, I guess, like, hey, who do you say that I am? And we just say, God, we thank you for this time. Would you continue to show us that throughout this conference? Amen.
Amen. Come on.
Amen, amen. Now, that's just the beginning of our day. We have so many things planned ahead, and I've got some notices to tell you so that you are prepared. So, we do have workshops today, so make sure that if you haven't chosen those yet, which you were supposed to go back and do last night, it's okay if you haven't, you can do this now on the app. Look for the button that says enroll. Or head to the HQ tent. Now, keynotes are on today. They start at 11 a.m. sharp. What time do they start? 11 a.m. sharp. Your session and your room is actually on the back of your name tag. So you should be able to have a look at that, have a look at the maps around the place, or ask a red shirt. If you do need some help trying to figure out where that room is. Now, don't move anywhere. We still have one more song. So we also have Mass today. So right after your keynote, which is at 11 a.m. sharp, we then have Mass at 12 p.m. So what time is Mass? 12, yes. So please head straight back here after your keynote. I'm ready for Mass. So what's happening right now is soon we're going to have one last song from Emmanuel Worship, and then it's morning tea time. So you're going to need to head towards the chapel to collect your morning tea. Now, speaking of your name tags that have all your session details on them, if you are in Ignite High, the high schoolers stream, can you please raise your hand or make some noise? Now, we should be able to tell who you are because you've got a green lanyard on. So if you are in high school and you're in the Ignite High stream and you do not have a green coloured lanyard and you've accidentally got a blue one, you need to go and switch yours over. Okay, so if you've got blue and you're in high school, you need to go to the HQ tent and ask for a green one, pretty please. Okay, so high schoolers, you should be in your cool green lanyards, and that's how we'll know who you are. So that's pretty much it from me. On your way out after our last song, make sure to grab a sticker on your way out. They're pretty groovy. They've got some cool things on them. So make sure as you head out the doors to grab your morning tea, to grab a sticker. So when is the keynote? 11. And when is Mass? 12. Great. Okay, so let's have one last song for Emmanuel Worship, and then we'll see you later.
Alrighty, why don't you get up on your feet and come sing along with us, wherever you are. Maybe you're standing in the seat.
Stand in the seat. Class, yes, yes. So good.
Alrighty, you ready?
No temptation has overtaken, 'cause God is faithful to us. Walls you've been watching for, at the sound of his voice, he has won for us. You have told us these things so that he to your arms. know you've overcome all my trials, all my trials and the giants that I face. Oh, my stillness is a grace that I will surely take.